Hi, good evening. Hello. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, teacher.
Good evening, teacher.
Hi, good evening. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay. I'm good. I'm good, thanks for asking. So let's begin. Tell me, what did we study last class?
Bien.
Ajá, ¿qué vimos la clase pasada?
No me acuerdo.
Ah, you don't remember.
Do you remember?
Ajá.
Can anyone tell? Raúl.
Ajá.
Modifiers which participle.
But okay, with participles.
Preposition.
Okay. And what else? Creo. Sí, comenzamos un nuevo tema. Veamos a ver si recuerdan qué fue lo que comenzamos a estudiar.
Presente perfecto.
Excellent. Present perfect. And what did we say we use it for? ¿Para qué lo usamos?
For actions that finished in the past, but we can speak in the moment.
Actions that finished in past?
But we can speak about that in the present.
Okay, for example?
I have been I don't remember. I have been to I don't remember.
Ajá, pero por ahí vamos.
Sorry.
I have been to learn English for 2 months.
Have you ever been in Spain?
Okay. I have learned or I have studied English for the past 2 months. Okay. Have you ever been to Europe, for example? What else? Nope.
No, I haven't.
Okay.
No, I haven't ever eaten.
Ajá. Vaya, por ahí vamos. Tenemos una idea. Perfecto. Vaya, just to review. We said that we are going to use the present perfect when we talk about a time from the past until now. Okay. Dijimos que vamos a usar el presente perfecto cuando hablamos acerca de un tiempo del pasado hasta ahora. Ejemplo, a person's life. Okay, you can tell me, I have studied English for the past 2 months. He estudiado inglés por los últimos 2 meses. O probablemente me diga, he estudiado inglés por los últimos 5 meses. Or probably 2 years, 3 years. I don't know how long you've been studying. No sé cuánto tiempo han estado estudiando ustedes. Okay. Another one that you can tell me is that you have had many different jobs. So if I ask, how many jobs have you had? ¿Cuántos trabajos han tenido?
I have been to the jobs.
Two?
Jobs.
Okay.
I have two.
Two? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, because I was working in the call center, the Office Gurus, auxiliar contable.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Excellent.
In my first job, I work for 20 years.
Wow, 20 years.
Yes, yes.
I joined 20 years in lawyer.
Uh-huh. Okay, and how about the others?
Only one. Yes.
Okay. Let me see. I have been in one of those three. Wow. Okay. I have had 9 jobs.
You?
Yes.
But only the teacher.
No, I started in a call center. I started working at sites. Then I went to Telus. Then I started teaching at Itexal. Then I went to Ciudadela Don Bosco. Then I moved to the place that I'm working right now. And during the pandemic, I got another job at TEPE, Teleperformance, and I got this one as well. And yeah, so I've been in different places.
I would like to work in Teleperformance, but the English that is very advanced.
To be honest with you, I don't think so. Because I had some co-workers that, for me, they were not, well, they didn't have the right level. So, I don't know how they do it, but in my opinion, that's my personal opinion, they didn't have the 85% of English that some call centers are asking for, but they were there working, and that's really nice. Because they give you the opportunity to work and also to continue studying. So it's really nice. It's a really nice company, honestly.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah, so you can see that here we've been talking about the different jobs that some of us have had. So we've been working in different places. And so probably some of you, as Edwin and Jeanette said, you have worked 20 years for the same company, and that's really nice, or you worked basically because you're not there anymore. Okay, then another thing that we were talking about last Thursday is that we are going to use the present perfect for something that started in the past and continues in the present. Okay, hablamos de esto también, que dijimos que vamos a usar el presente perfecto para algo que comenzó en el pasado y que aún continúa en el presente. I remember that Lily said that she has been married for 16 years. Recuerdo que Lily nos decía que ella ha estado casada por 16 años. Okay? In the examples that you were talking, so let's suppose that you were still working in the same company. You have worked in the same company for 20 years. En el caso de que hubieran, de que siguieran en la misma empresa. You have worked 20 years in the same company. Han trabajado en la misma empresa por 20 años. Okay? Comenzó en el pasado y aún está en tiempo presente. Si yo les pregunto, ¿cuánto tiempo llevan estudiando inglés? Ustedes me pueden decir, ¿qué? 2 años, 5 meses, etc. Es algo que iniciaron en el pasado, pero que aún en tiempo presente siguen estudiando. ¿Ok? And I remember we were discussing about this as well. Estábamos hablando de esto también. That when we say something we have done several times in the past and continue to do. Decíamos varias cosas que, bueno, cosas que hemos hecho varias veces en el pasado y que aún en tiempo presente lo hacemos. So for example, if I ask, how many of you like cooking? ¿Cuántos de ustedes les gusta cocinar?
Me.
Me.
Okay. And how
Dresser.
Long? Excellent. ¿Y hace cuánto están cocinando o cocinan?
20 years.
20 years cooking?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. What else?
Maybe 10 years.
10 years?
Yes.
Okay.
Maybe 5 years.
5 years, okay. Excellent. Okay, y ahí vimos esta comparación, ¿verdad? El presente simple con el presente perfecto. También vimos cómo hacer oraciones afirmativas, negativas, y cómo hacer preguntas. Okay. Eso fue lo que vimos el día jueves. Okay, any questions?
No, teacher.
No? Okay. No. So no, we will continue. Vamos a continuar entonces. Y vamos a ver entonces el video que está ahí en la plataforma. Okay. And this is about the present perfect with already and yet. Okay. So let's begin. Vamos entonces allá. And if you have questions, please let me know. Igual, si no escuchan, me avisan. So there we go.
Hi, in this lesson, we will study present perfect with already and yet. Ask and answer questions in present perfect with irregular and regular past participles.
I want you to concentrate on this new tense. Notice how it is formed. Pay close attention to the words already and yet.
Present perfect. Already, yet. The present perfect is formed with the verb have plus the past participle.
Have you been to a jazz club?
Yes, I've been to several.
No, I haven't been to one.
Has she ridden in a streetcar?
Yes, she's ridden in one.
No, she hasn't ridden in one.
Has he called home lately?
Yes, he's called twice this week.
No, he hasn't called in months.
Have they eaten dinner yet?
Yes, they've already eaten.
No, they haven't eaten yet.
Contractions.
I've equals I have. You've equals you have. He's equals he has. She's equals she has. It's equals it has. We've equals we have. They've equals they have. Haven't equals have not. Hasn't equals has not.
For present perfect, we will use have or has plus past participle verb plus complement. The verb have or has will depend on the person we will talk about. We use present perfect when we want to express actions which began in the past and continue in the present. Example, she has worked in the bank for 5 years. We have had the same car for 10 years. When we want to make reference to an unfinished temporary period of time, I have worked hard this week. It has rained a lot this year. We haven't seen her today. Repeated actions in a specific period of time between the present and the past. They have seen that film 6 times. We have eaten all that restaurant many times. When timing is not relevant or it is unknown, someone has eaten my soup. Now let's talk about already and yet. Already usually goes after have or has and before the main verb. Examples, we have already had our breakfast. When are you going to do your homework? but I've already done it. Yet means that something that we expected has happened or hasn't happened. We usually put it at the end of a sentence. Examples: has the post arrived yet? Have you done your homework? Not yet. Haven't you got ready yet? Look at the time.
Okay, so you can see that there we have the present perfect, and we are going to be studying already and yet. So we have here the present perfect is formed with the verb have plus the past participle. Ahí tenemos cómo vamos a ir formando lo que es el presente perfecto, ¿verdad? Aquí tenemos lo que es el verbo, o en este caso el auxiliar have, más el verbo en pasado participio. So let me see. Stephanie, can you read the first two questions, please?
Okay. How you been to Aya's club? Yes. Only question.
Continue, please.
Okay, okay. Yes, I've been to several. No, I haven't been to one. Has she ridden in a streetcar? Yes, she's ridden in one. No, she hasn't ridden in one.
Thank you. Saul, can you continue, please?
Has the college home lately? Yes, he's called
twice.
This week. Why?
Okay, the pronunciation is twice.
Twice. This week. No, he hasn't called in months. Have they eaten dinner yet? Yes, they be already eaten. ¿Cómo? No
Iren?
Sé cómo. Eaten? No, they haven't eaten yet.
Okay, thank you. So you can see that here we have those questions, those are yes, no questions, and we have the answers. Okay, now you can see that here we have contractions. So we have I've, that is, I have. You've, you have. He's, he has. She's, she has. And it's, it has. Be careful. Aquí sí hay que tener cuidado, ¿verdad? How do I know that I'm using the present perfect and not the verb be? ¿Cómo sé yo que estoy usando el presente perfecto y no el verbo to be?
For the verb.
The verb. Past participle.
The verb.
Ah, okay. Excellent. Voy a identificar que estoy usando el presente perfecto porque después voy a tener un verbo. ¿En qué dijeron?
Past participle.
In past participle. Excellent. Perfect. So let's continue. Then we have we've, we have. They've, they have. Okay? And we have here the negative contractions that we have haven't, that is equal to have not, and hasn't, that is equals to has not. Okay? ¿Alguna pregunta acerca de esto? No. Okay, excellent. So you can see that for the present perfect, we will use have or has plus the past participle of the verb plus the complement, okay? And as it says here, the verb have or has will depend on the person that we are talking about. Ya eso es algo que habíamos visto, ¿verdad? Que el have o el has va a depender del sujeto del que esté hablando. Es decir, ¿cuándo voy a usar have?
Cuando es en primera persona.
Ajá.
También en plural.
Okay. ¿Y cuáles son los de plural?
You, we, they.
Excellent. ¿Y cuándo voy a usar has?
In third person.
He, she, and?
It.
Excellent. Okay. Vaya, veo que esto sí está claro. Sigamos acá entonces. Okay. So this is something, well, you can see that here we have some other uses. When we make reference to an unfinished temporary period of time. Let me see. Abigail, can you read it, please?
Yes. I have worked hard this week. It has rained a lot this year. We haven't seen her today.
Thank you. Okay, sorry. Veronica, can you continue, please? Veronica Ramirez?
Yes.
Okay.
We haven't seen her today.
No, acá, repeated actions.
A repeated action in a specific period of time between the present and the past. They had seen that film six times. We had eaten at that restaurant many times.
Okay, thank you. So you can see that here we have repeated actions in a specific period of time. Let's see what else do we have here. Okay, and it says that when time is not relevant or it is unknown. También tenemos que cuando el tiempo no es relevante o es desconocido. So let me see, we're going to have, let me see who's going to read. Janet.
Yes, teacher. When timing is not relevant or it's unknown, so one has eaten my soup.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Y tenemos la última, ¿verdad? Que dice que cuando el tiempo no es relevante o es desconocido. The example, someone has eaten my soup. Okay, so now it says, let's talk about already and yet. Let me see. Give me a few seconds. Give me a few seconds. Okay. Lillian, can you continue, please?
Okay. ¿Por dónde exactamente? Already.
Already.
Okay. Already usually goes after have or has and before the main verb. Examples. We've already had our breakfast. When are you going to do your homework? But I've already done it.
Okay, excellent. So you can see we have already. And it says that it usually goes after have or has and before the main verb. So you can see the example we have. We've already had our breakfast. So you can see here we have the auxiliary have and here we have the main verb. So already will go between the auxiliary and the main verb. Then we have, when are you going to do your homework? But I've already done it. El already, como dice acá, ¿verdad? Generalmente va a ir en medio de lo que es el auxiliar y del verbo principal. Do you know what already means? ¿Saben lo que significa el already?
Ya, ya.
Ya. Ok. Ya. Excellent. Cuando me dicen, teacher, yo ya hice mi tarea. I've already done my homework. Ya he hecho mi tarea. Okay. Any questions?
No.
No? Okay. So let's go with yet. It says, let me see who's going to read. Franklin, please.
Okay. The means of yet.
Yes, please.
Okay. Yet means that something that we expect has happened or hasn't happened. We usually put at the end of a sentence. Examples. Has the boss arrived yet? Have you done your homework? Not yet. Haven't you got ready yet? Look at the time.
Okay, thank you. So you can see here that we have the use of yet, and it says that means that something that we expected has happened or hasn't happened. Okay, and usually is going to go at the end of a sentence or question. Okay, otra cosa que sí deben de tener bien en cuenta es que el yet generalmente siempre va a ir o bien en preguntas o en oraciones negativas. Ok, en cambio, already va a ir en oraciones afirmativas. Okay? Ok, so we have the question: has the post arrived yet? Si ustedes se dan cuenta, va hasta el final. Then we have you done your homework? Not yet. Aquí tengo lo que es una negativa, por lo cual utilizo lo que es el yet. Haven't you got ready yet? Look at the time. Ok. Generalmente el yet va a ir hasta el final de la oración o de la pregunta y se va a utilizar en oraciones negativas o enunciados interrogativos. Y el already solamente va a ir con oraciones afirmativas. ¿Preguntas?
No.
No questions?
No, no questions.
Okay. Okay, so let me just look for an exercise that I have here. Vamos a ver qué tan cierto es entonces. Okay, so let me share this right now with you. Okay, just give me a few seconds. Okay, so this is what we were studying. So I'm going to share it right now with you. Here it is. Okay. Right, esto es lo que estábamos viendo. Lo del presente perfecto. Okay, this is something that we already seen. And we have here these exercises. So, for example, it says, complete the sentences with a verb from the list. Es de completar lo que son esas oraciones con un verbo de la lista. For example, number one, Jocelyn. Jocelyn Larín.
Yes, teacher.
So, for example, number one.
Read.
Yeah, can you read it, please?
Can I have this newspaper? Yes, I finished with it.
Okay, thank you. Let's see the next one. Let me see. Jocelyn Marroquin, number two.
Okay. I buy sería some new shoes. Ajá, buy.
Ajá. Recuerde que es presente perfecto.
I have sería entonces.
Ajá, I have.
I have buy.
¿Cuál es el participio del verbo buy?
Bought.
I have bought some new shoes. Do you want to see them?
Okay, excellent. Do you want to see them? Okay, Sandra, number three.
What is this? She has went out.
Went?
Out.
¿Cuál es el participio de go?
Gone.
Pass.
Gone,
okay. So the answer is going to be she
has gone out.
Excellent. She has gone out. Number four, Edwin.
Look, somebody.
Number four, I'm looking.
Oh, pardon. I'm looking for Paula.
This is a question.
Yes. Have you seen her?
Excellent. Have you seen her? Okay, let's see the next one. Delia. Number five. Delia?
Yes, teacher. Okay. Estoy revisando los...
okay.
¿Cuál es Falton?
Estamos acá en la número 5. Look, somebody.
Look, somebody. Maybe break. ¿Cómo se dice?
Break.
Permítame, break. Pero con somebody, no sé si es somebody have, maybe. Broken, no.
Okay, somebody.
No sé cómo se pondría el have.
Has.
Somebody has, oh, sí, es en tercera persona, es cierto.
Uh-huh.
Somebody has broken that window.
Excellent. Thank you. Let's see, Lillian, the next one.
Okay. Does Lisa know that you're going away? Sería, I have invited her. No.
Nope.
I tell.
Ajá, y el participio. Excellent.
I have told her.
Perfect. Let's see the next one. Abigail.
Yeah. The seven.
Yes.
I can find my umbrella. Somebody. Sing it.
Somebody.
Sing it.
No.
Somebody. Take it.
¿Cuál es el participio de take?
as
taken.
It is taken.
Okay. So somebody
taken.
¿Qué le hace falta allí?
Somebody has.
Somebody has
taken.
Taken it. Okay, excellent. Let's see the next one. Franklin.
Yeah. I'm looking for Sarah. Where has he seen? Oh,
have
no.
You sorry, it says I'm looking for Sarah.
Where has she gone?
Excellent. Stephanie, the next one. Stephanie? Okay, I don't know what happened to her. Let's see, Walter. Number 9.
Okay. I know the woman, but I forget has her name. I forget it. Has her name? No. I have.
Es presente perfecto. Ajá, I have.
Forget her name.
¿Cuál es el participio de forget?
Forgot.
Okay, but I have forgotten.
Forgotten.
Uh-huh. Okay, but I have forgotten her name. Esto es algo muy común de la teacher. Okay, so sorry. Cada rato se me olvidan los nombres. Okay, excellent. Let's see the next one, Veronica.
Sue is having a party tonight. She has invited a lot of people.
Excellent. Let's see the next one. Let me see who's missing. ¿Quiénes me hace falta? Let me check. Edwin.
What are you going to do? What are you going to do?
We only have two verbs. Ya solo nos vienen quedando dos verbos.
Yes.
They have here, not see, and decide.
Have you decided?
Okay, excellent. And the last one, Janet.
Where are my glasses? I don't know. I know. See?
Remember that it is present perfect. Es presente perfecto.
I know.
I have. No.
I haven't.
Seen.
I haven't seen.
Okay, excellent. I haven't
them.
Seen them. Okay, perfect. Vaya, con este pequeño ejercicio, ¿está claro o tienen dudas?
I think that is only for practice, teacher.
Yes. Sí, la verdad que se necesita lo que es bastante práctica. So, let me see. Give me a few seconds. Okay. Bueno, estábamos viendo lo que era el already y yet, right? So I'll continue with that. Vamos a continuar con eso entonces. Y de igual manera vamos a hacer unos ejercicios. So you can see we have I've already and I haven't yet or have you yet. Okay, aquí es lo que les explicaba, ¿verdad? Que el already casi siempre va a ir con lo que son oraciones afirmativas. So Stephanie, can you help me reading this information, please?
Yes. Okay. Already, before you expected, what time are Diane and Paul coming? They already arrived. Before you
expected. Okay.
Okay, expected. Okay.
Thank you. Continue, sorry.
Okay. It's only 9 o'clock and Anne has already gone to bed before I expected. John, this is Mary. Yes, I know. We've already met.
Met.
Okay,
thank you. So, if you can see, we have already, and as it says, it's before you expected, or before I expected. So, what time are Diane and Paul coming? Eso, o sea, algo que ya supera las expectativas, ¿verdad? O sea, por decirlo así, antes de lo que nosotros esperábamos. They've already arrived. O sea, ellos ya llegaron. ¿A qué hora vienen Diana y Paul? Ellos ya llegaron. Then we have, it's only 9 o'clock and Anne has already gone to bed. Es cuando, por ejemplo, ustedes ven que su familia se va ya a dormir, generalmente son los que más noches se duermen. Se quedan así como que asombrados, ¿verdad? So it's something before you expected. Then we have, John, this is Mary. Yes, I know, we have already met. O sea, están presentándose, no sé si les ha pasado que les están presentando a alguien y dicen, ah, sí, ya nos conocíamos. Ya nos habíamos conocido antes, por ejemplo. Okay, and if you can notice here, we are only using affirmative sentences. Now, if we move to haven't yet or have you yet, you can see that yet means until now, okay? And you can use yet in negative sentences and questions. Esto es algo que les explicaba, que el yet will go in negative sentences and questions. And yet is usually at the end, okay? El yet generalmente va a ir hasta el final. So let's continue. Let me see. Jocelyn Marroquín, can you help me reading, please?
Okay, yet in negative sentence, are Diane and Paul here? No, they haven't arrived yet.
Arrived.
Arrived yet. But B expects Diane and Paul to arrive soon. Does John cannot doubt you're going away? No, I haven't told him yet, but B is going to tell him soon.
Soon.
Soon. Margaret has bought a new dress, but she hasn't worn it yet.
Okay, thank you. So you can see that here we have yet in negative sentences. Tenemos lo que es el yet en oraciones negativas. We have, are Diane and Paul here? No, they haven't arrived yet. No, ellos no han llegado aún. Pero dice que el B espera a que Diane y Paul lleguen pronto. Okay, then we have, does John know that you're going away? Nope, I haven't told him yet. No le he dicho aún. Pero dice que le va a decir pronto. Okay, then we have, Margaret has bought a new dress, but she hasn't worn it yet. Margaret ha comprado un nuevo vestido, pero no lo ha usado aún. Okay, no sé si esto les queda claro.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Teacher, so I have one. A question.
Go ahead.
Jet is similar still.
Aún, yes. Sí, es similar. O déjeme ver.
Okay.
Still, todavía. And yet, aún. No, entonces no lo es. Because here, en el contexto que lo estamos usando aquí ahorita, lo que es el yet es aún. They haven't arrived yet. Ellos aún no
sorry,
han llegado.
Sorry, con already.
El already es ya. Mm-hmm. Ellos ya llegaron. Y es una oración still, afirmativa.
Still is todavía o aún.
Okay. Sorry, I got confused. ¿Cómo sería el still con el already o con el yet?
Con already.
Ah, okay. With already. Okay, give me a few seconds. Déjame ver si eso lo tengo acá. Porque me pasé una parte que no... Que es el just. That is a short time ago. Okay. Let me check. Aquí tengo los ejercicios. Have you ever? Aquí son las preguntas. How long? Igual preguntas. Let me see here. For since and ago. No, eso es algo que ya vamos a estudiar. Igual esto. Lo vamos a estudiar en estos días. No, no me sale acá. So I don't have it here. No, we don't have it here. Okay, so let's look it up right now. Veamos entonces ahorita. Just give me a few seconds. Because you can see here. Aquí se lo puede ver, and yet in questions. Have Diane and Paul arrived yet? No, not yet. We're still waiting for them. Let's see another example.
Has
Linda started her new job yet? No, she starts next week. Then we have, this is my new dress. Oh, it's nice. Have you worn it yet? So you can see that here, el still está en una oración, ¿qué? ¿Afirmativa o negativa?
Negativa.
Afirmativa.
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 Ok, okay. Yes. Entonces, según lo que estamos viendo allí, lo vamos a utilizar siempre en una oración afirmativa o negativa. O generalmente en una oración afirmativa o negativa.
Afirmativa tendría que ser.
Ok. Sí, y de igual manera se va a utilizar para describir una acción que no ha terminado, ¿verdad?
Ah, okay.
Yes, for example, you can say, I'm still working for the same company, for example. Okay?
Okay.
Yes, y la diferencia sería que yo la estoy utilizando para lo que es una oración afirmativa. En cambio, el yet generalmente siempre va a ir con
negativa.
Negativas
o pregunta.
y preguntas, ¿ok?
Yes.
¿Ok?
Ok, thank you.
You're welcome. Yes.
Este, también con eso, ahorita estaba viendo, preguntando y me dijeron de que se puede usar el yet como para algo que aún no se está haciendo y el still como algo que ya se está haciendo.
Sí, decíamos, I'm still working, yo, but, sí, les decía, I'm still working in the same company. O sea, es algo que tenemos o llevamos haciendo por cierto periodo de tiempo. Thank you, Delia. O como lo dice acá, ¿verdad? Quiero ver, el yet viene a tener el significado que es
hasta. Igual también.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Igual cuando el yet está en diferente posición de la oración.
Por ejemplo.
Entiendo que es diferente. O sea, cuando no está al final, según la regla que había presentado usted en el video, que sale que es al final siempre.
Sí.
Pero no sé si también se puede poner en otro lugar de la oración.
Usualmente siempre va a ir hasta el final.
Creo.
¿Perdón? Vaya, okay. En el video me decía usted, vamos ahorita, ¿lo logran ver? No.
No.
No, no lo ven, vaya, permítanme. Vamos ahorita entonces. So, here we go. Nope. Acá está. So, you can see here. Has the post arrived yet? ¿Está? Al final de lo que es la pregunta. Ahora bien, have you done your homework? Not yet. Está hasta el final. Ahora bien, haven't you got ready yet? Si se dan cuenta, acá tengo lo que es una pregunta. Y el yet está al final de la pregunta. Ahora bien, look at the time. Ya es una oración completamente diferente. ¿Ok? Y como lo dice aquí, generalmente va a ir al final de la oración. O en el caso acá también, de la pregunta. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Teacher.
Yes.
Yo, lo para, a mi perspectiva, es still algo que está sucediendo, digamos, aún sucede, y yet es aún no sucede.
Correcto.
Uh-huh. Para mí, ver, así de sencillo es.
Ok. Excelente. Sí, en pocas palabras, ¿verdad? O más simple. No sé si hay otra duda o pregunta.
No.
No.
Ok. ¿Logran ver la pantalla? Lo que estábamos leyendo.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Ok. So, let's see. We have here. To complete the sentences, use already plus present perfect. Veamos, tenemos el already más el presente perfecto. Let me see, Stephanie. Number two.
Okay. Do Sus and Bill want to see the films? No, they...
Ajá, they
already saw.
No, what is that?
Already sim. I don't know.
Yes, they already
seen
it.
It.
Okay. Sí, seen ellos it. Ya okay. La vieron. Okay.
Okay.
Let's see the next one. Let me see, Janet.
Don't forget to phone Tom already.
I already
phoned.
Yeah, you can say I've already phoned to him. Okay. Thank you. Let's see the next one. Sandra. Sandra Vázquez.
When is Martin going away?
Ajá.
He has already. He has already.
Ajá, he has already.
He has already going away.
Going. El participio del verbo go.
Gone.
Okay, so the answer is going to be?
He has already gone.
Gone away. Okay, excellent. Let's see, number five. Walter.
Do you want to read the newspaper? I already read the newspaper. I have already read. I have already read.
The pronunciation. Read.
I read the newspaper.
Okay, excellent. And the last one. Let me see, Abigail.
When does Linda start her new job? She has started. She has already started her new job.
Okay, excellent. She has already started her new job. Okay. Okay. Vaya. Hasta acá. ¿Preguntas?
No.
No.
Teacher, cuando es anybody también no. Se puede usar el has.
Vaya, cuando estamos hablando de anybody, somebody, everybody, no one, y eso.
There are incontable.
Okay, ahí usamos, los utilizamos como si fuera tercera persona. Entonces, es decir, ahí estaría usando lo que es el has. Everybody has paid attention, for example. Okay. A pesar que estoy como decía ahí Franklin, that they are uncountable.
Yeah.
Okay. Vaya, a pesar que no estoy siendo específica por decirlo así, o sea, yo vengo y utilizo lo que en este caso sería el has. Si estoy hablando en presente usando el verbo to be, sería is. Okay, everybody is in class. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
I have a question.
Ajá.
Yo vi que ahí en una oración, después de already estaba phone. Y ese se ocuparía como verbo.
Sí, o sea, yo sé que lo puedo traducir como teléfono, ¿verdad? Pero también lo traduzco como un verbo que es llamar. Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
The same happens with the word book. So.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay. I have a question. ¿Todos ustedes van al día con la plataforma?
Yes.
¿Sí?
Yes.
No, teacher.
No.
Ya la terminé.
Ya la terminó. Okay. Perfecto.
I finished today.
Okay. Solo las partes del examen final me faltan.
Ah, pero ya vamos al día, perfecto.
Yeah, sí, solamente. Esta semana estuve en parciales de la universidad y por eso.
Ah, vaya, está bien, no se preocupe. Vaya, sí, solamente les preguntaba, ¿verdad? Para saber si habían tenido alguna dificultad o si todo estaba claro. Ok. Vaya, el último ejercicio, ¿de cuál es, Verónica?
El reading.
Ah, el reading. Mm-hmm. Del final test.
Yes.
Vaya. Vamos a hacerlo revisando entonces. Pero aparte de ello, ¿no han tenido algún otro problema?
Yo solo con dos oraciones del final test.
Ajá, veamos cuáles son.
el D, la número 2 y 4, que lo puse de mil formas y no.
¿Dónde tienen que ordenar?
Yes.
Ajá, veamos cómo estaba poniendo, cómo está poniendo.
Vaya, en la número 2, Sam does have a mustache and wear glasses.
Ajá.
Y me sale mala.
¿Es pregunta?
No, no la tengo como, al menos yo no la puse como pregunta, y la puse como pregunta y tampoco me...
Ok, si usted se fija, tengo lo que es el signo de interrogación. En la número 2 me sale al final el signo de interrogación, lo cual me da a entender que es una pregunta.
Permítame, ¿dónde?
Bueno.
Está where, está la palabra where.
Where, mustache, ajá.
Have, sun, a, a, dos, glasses, and... And end.
Ajá. Vaya, pero en la línea, por decirlo así, donde usted tiene que completar, al final de esa línea hay un signo de interrogación.
Ah, yes, yes.
Ok. Sorry. So, eso le da a entender que es una pregunta.
Sí, sí.
Y la otra me decía, ¿qué es la número?
El número 4.
The same, we have that it is a question. Es una pregunta, la número 4 también.
Yes, esa le he dejado. Who's the person sitting next to on the couch? Sorry.
Uh-huh.
Who's the person sitting on next to? No. Es que la he modificado tantas veces que.
Pero vamos bien al inicio. Who's the person?
Who's the person sitting?
Uh-huh.
Next to Jason on the couch.
Ok. Sí, esa es una opción, pero no sé por qué le sale mala. ¿Le sí, estará poniendo signo o punto al final?
No, no le he puesto punto. Y el signo sí lo tiene.
Ajá. Uh-huh. Vale, entonces sería de revisar.
También podría ser que no haya escrito fácil. O que haya escrito mal alguna cosa. No sé.
Sí, revise sí, cómo ha escrito sitting, si va con dos T's.
Yes. Que está bien, ya revisé esa.
A mí me estuvo dando también problemas con apóstrofe, entonces tal vez por ahí también puede ser.
Ah, también que no haya puesto tilde, que haya puesto un tilde, la tilde y no el apóstrofe.
Quiero ver.
No, el apóstrofe. Puso el nombre de Jason, que no le puso el nombre, la letra mayor.
Ah, también.
Voy a revisar.
Va.
Voy a revisar.
Ok.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Vaya, si no hay más preguntas, nos quedamos hasta acá y nos veríamos hasta mañana.
Ok.
Ok,
so that's all for today. Thank you. Bye.
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 Good night.
Bye.